Good morning.
Good morning.
Welcome to Christ our Redeemer Lutheran Church. We're glad that you're here today to worship with us, either in present physical form or through other means, whatever they may be. As we gather, an old story tells of a stranger walking in the streets of a noisy city. He listens, stops, and finds a cricket on the street that no one has noticed. He drops some coins on the pavement, and everyone hears and stops. In the gospel today, no one but Jesus noticed the copper coins amid the large sums placed in the offering box. But he did not hear the coins. He heard the sound of a great band. This woman gave her all, trusting in the Lord alone. We live in times of great abundance. Great abundance does not produce generosity, but faith does. From the generous God who has given us all things in Christ, we learn to live as a generous people. The grace of God is sufficient for all things we need today and for our eternal salvation. So let us pray. Almighty God, we thank you for our abundance. The food we have, the shelter, the family, the blessings of health and fellowship, but most of all, for the abundance of your grace, your love and your mercy. It comes through salvation that is found in Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord. Bless us this day in our worship. May we praise you. May you fill our hearts with joy and renewed faith. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
Please stand as we sing the first hymn.
I'm
of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Blessed are those whose strength is in the Lord.
In whose hearts are the highways to Zion.
You know the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, that though he was rich,
he became poor, so that by his poverty we might become rich.
Let us confess our sins to God our Father.
I confess to God Almighty, before the whole of the inhabitants, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have sinned in thought, word, and deed, by my fault, by my own fault, by my own most grievous fault. Therefore, I pray, God Almighty, to have mercy on me, forgive me all my sins, and bring me to everlasting life. Amen.
The Almighty, merciful God, Lord, grant you pardon, forgiveness, and remission of all your sins. As a called servant of Christ and by his authority, I therefore forgive you all your sins. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
May the Lord, who has begun this good work in us, bring it to completion on the day of our Lord Jesus Christ. Promises to those who trust in you. Grant us so firmly to believe in your Son, Jesus Christ, that our faith may never be found wanting. Through the same Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
Please be seated.
Of the day. This is the last Sunday of the church year. As the long green season of the Sundays after Pentecost comes to an end, in our service today we hear of the mite given in faith, in contrast to the bigger offerings given to cover the sins of the giver. The Old Testament tells a familiar story of Elijah and the widow and the flour and oil that were not spent. In the epistle we are reminded that Christ came once to bear the sins of the world and will come again to save those who wait for him. In the gospel, Jesus tells the story of a poor widow's mite that speaks of faith, while the offering of the rich stand in judgment against their unrepentant hearts. The Old Testament reading is from 1 Kings chapter 17, beginning at verse 8. Then the word of the Lord came to Elijah, "Arise and go to Zarephath, which belongs to Sidon, and dwell there. Behold, I have commanded a widow there to feed you." So he arose and went to Zarephath. And when he came to the gate of the city, behold, a widow was there, gathering sticks. And he called to her and said, "Bring me a little water in a vessel that I may drink." And as she was going to bring it, he called to her and said, "Bring me a morsel of bread in your hand." And she said, "As the Lord your God lives, I have nothing baked, only a handful of flour in a jar, and a little oil in a jug. And now I am gathering a couple sticks that I may go in and prepare it for myself and my son, that we may eat it and die." And Elijah said to her, "Do not fear. Go in and do as you have said. But first make me a little cake out of it and bring it to me. And afterwards make something for yourself and your son. For thus says the Lord, the God of Israel, the jar of flour shall not be spent, and the jug of oil shall not be empty until the Lord, day the Lord sends rain upon the earth." And she went, and she did as Elijah said, and she and he and her household ate for many days. The jar of flour was not spent, neither did the jug of oil become empty, according to the word of the Lord that he spoke to Elijah. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our epistle reading this morning is from Hebrews chapter 9, beginning at verse 24. For Christ had entered not into holy places made with hands, which are copies of the true thing, but into heaven itself, now to appear in the presence of God on our behalf. Nor was it to offer himself repeatedly, as the high priest enters the holy place every year with blood not of his own, for then he would have had to suffer repeatedly since the foundation of the world. But as it is, he has appeared once for all at the end of the ages to put away the sins by the sacrifice of himself. And just as it is appointed for man to die once, and after that comes judgment, so Christ, having been offered once, bears the sins of many, will appear a second time, not to deal with sin, but to save those who are eagerly waiting for him. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
In the marketplaces and have the best seats in the synagogue, in the places of honor at feasts, who devour widows' houses and for pretense make long prayers. They will receive the greater condemnation. And he sat down opposite the treasury and watched the people putting money into the offering box. Many rich people put in large sums, and a poor widow came and put in two small copper coins. Make a penny. And he called his disciples to him and said to them, "Truly I say to you, this poor widow has put in more than all those who are contributing to the offering box. For they all contributed out of their abundance, but she gave out of her poverty. She has put in everything she had, all she had to live on. This is the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ."
Please be seated.
Celebrated today, one of the oldest festivals of the church year, It is an opportunity to remember before God those whom we have known and loved, who have been called away by God recently, or even more distantly, by death. If today's message was summarized in one word, that word could well be remember. Today we remember before God those whom we have known and loved. Remember is a fitting word for All Saints Day because, well, quite simply, those whom we remember before God today are worth remembering. They were, after all, still are in our remembering, precious gifts of God. At least God thinks so. One of the prayers in the funeral liturgy describes them as those whom you have given us, O Lord, to know and to love in our pilgrimage. Just as Thanksgiving Day at the end of this month reminds us that all of God's gifts are worthy of acknowledgement, All Saints Day at the beginning of the month reminds us that among those greatest gracious gifts of God are those whom we remember, whom God has given us to remember and to love in our pilgrimage. Remembering, of course, those whom we have known and loved. But that remembering may not be without its pain. In fact, if we do it thoughtfully, we may find that remembering places us right in the middle of the Beatitudes, the words of Jesus, which are the gospel lesson for All Saints Day. There Jesus mentions specifically those who mourn. But some of the other terms he uses may also apply to our grieving. He mentions the poor in spirit, those who feel that they have had the wind knocked out of them, the meek, those folks who find themselves dealing with circumstances beyond their control, and those who hunger and thirst for righteousness. They can often be people who are asking questions and seeking answers which elude them. Questions like, why did they have to die? Those of us whose wounds are recent may recognize all the more those titles painfully that we read about in the Beatitudes. But if remembering the dead and the death of loved ones puts us squarely in the midst of the first Beatitudes, which speak of grief we experience, it places us also in the midst of the next Beatitudes. Remembering those whom surrounded and upheld us in our grieving, who consoled and encouraged us with mercy and goodness and kindness and hopefulness, care and compassion, who tried to share what we endured. All those saints on earth who embodied for us the love of God and Jesus Christ as our loved ones died. And those who encouraged us and embodied the love of God and Jesus Christ just as our loved ones did while they were still alive and with us. Remembering our loved ones in our caring and grieving can be a sign of God's goodness in having given them to us. I'm not sure we always think of grief that way. The fact of grieving says that those whom we mourn are worth remembering. And that brings us to the other one for today. If the word for All Saints Day is remember, a second word for this day might well be rejoice. Remember and rejoice. almost sounds like a non sequitur, doesn't it? Remember and feel bad. We can relate to that. Remember and rejoice. It may be a bit harder to come by. But that is the very message of the Christian gospel. The outcome of the hope that God has given us in the death and resurrection of Jesus Christ. Not a rejoicing that ignores the pain of grief, nor even one that rises above all of that pain, but one that is able to rejoice in all things. Remember and rejoice. Rejoice that we had them as precious gifts of God as long as we did, to know and to love in our pilgrimage. It could have been otherwise, you know. God might have never given them to us at all, or given them to us for a much shorter time than he did, or made them far less worthy of being remembered than they were. The purpose of All Saints Day is not so much to remember that our loved ones died, but that they lived. When the church throughout the centuries collects the stories of fine Christians of the past to be remembered and emulated, they don't title the books The Deaths of the Saints, but rather The Lives of the Saints. By the grace of God, before they died, they lived. Yes, sometimes poor in spirit, mournful, meek, and needy, but also merciful, pure in heart, devoted to peace and righteousness. That's how you remember yours, isn't it? Remember and rejoice. Because before they died, they lived. Rejoice not only because they live, but because they live. That is the funeral and final message after all, isn't it? And that is why we still are bold to celebrate today. We remember them before God. Because that is where, by great grace in Jesus Christ, they are. Before God. They are in his hands. For them, the promise of the Beatitudes are now fulfilled in God's eternal presence. And there is no doubt. Theirs is the kingdom of heaven. They have obtained mercy. They are called children of God. They see God. And it could have been the other way, of course. That death, or worse, would be the end for them. After all, if we are honest, death is what we deserve as well. No less. It's probably all they deserve as well. Except that he in whose hands they now rest was with them in their death. In Jesus Christ, our God himself lived for us the Beatitudes. He was poor in spirit, meek and mournful, dedicated to righteousness, mercy and peace, pure in heart, persecuted, reviled, crucified, dead and buried, and raised by God to life again. Because even in the midst of death itself, God remembered, and God rejoiced. and what his Son had done for all the saints. That now becomes the word for us on All Saints Day. Remember, even though it be with tears perhaps and painful for a while, remember, for God himself who gave them to us has declared in Jesus Christ that they are worth remembering. Remembering not just that they died, but that they lived. And that they live as we shall too. For God himself remembers us as he remembered them. Today, before God, we join our Lord himself in the celebration of all the saints as we remember and rejoice. Amen. Now may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be and abide with us all. Amen.
Please rise and join me in our confession of faith found in the words of the Nicene Creed. I believe in one God,
Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and of all things visible and invisible, and in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, begotten of his Father before all worlds, God of God, light of light, very God of very God, begotten, not made, being of one substance with the Father, by whom all things were made, who for us men and for our salvation came down from heaven and was incarnate by the Holy Spirit of the Virgin Mary, and was made man, and was crucified also for us under Pontius Pilate. He suffered and was buried. The third day he rose again according to the Scriptures, and ascended into heaven, and sits at the right hand of the Father. And he will come again with glory to judge both the living and the dead, whose kingdom will have no end. And I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord and giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son together is worshipped and glorified, who spoke by the prophets. And I believe in one holy Christian and apostolic church. I acknowledge one baptism for the remission of sins, and I look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
We find offer plates at the back and to the side, so if you haven't contributed, please feel free to do so. Let us sing. Church, those who serve her as ministers and all her members, they would come with repentant hearts before the Lord and be grateful for the mercy that sustains us in this life and gives us life everlasting. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For our president, governor, congress, legislatures, judges, and magistrates, that we be protected from our enemies and preserved in freedom to serve the Lord without constraint and with clear conscience. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the rich, that they be grateful for their blessings and use them in service to those in need. And for the poor, that God would sustain them and keep them from bitterness and complaint. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For this congregation, our pastor and all our parish leaders, that the Lord equip us with the spirit of humility, that we walk in his ways and confess faithfully his gospel before all people. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the sick, the suffering, the aged, the infirm, those in their last days, and those who grieve for those they have lost, especially those in our heart, that the Lord grant them healing in accordance with his will, grace to endure the day of trouble, and peace at last. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For gratitude and thanksgiving, that we use the resources the Lord has supplied to honor his name, and that we return to him the tithes and offering he is due for all his mercies. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the grace of the Holy Spirit, that we be prepared in body and soul to receive the Lord's body and blood in this holy communion, and be strengthened in faith and love for him and for all people. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Let's remember those who lost in the past year. David Cowell. Grace Wayne. Linda Schatz. Barbara Gentry. Reverend Gary Bell. Ima Beach. Gordon Bickers. Martha Huffstetler. Mike Cox. Bernie Brickley. Jan Fields. Dennis Beach. Lily Hanley. Maddie Tucker. David Ryan. Julie Hanson. Joey Cascio. Dan Copeland. Larry Price. And Cody Angelmeyer. As well as all those we don't know that passed away due to COVID-19. Into your hands, O Lord, we commend all for whom we pray, trusting in your mercy through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give him thanks and praise.
It is truly good, right, and salutary that we should at all times and all places give thanks to you, Holy Lord, Almighty Father, everlasting God, through Jesus Christ our Lord, who out of love for his fallen creation humbled himself by taking on the form of a servant, becoming obedient unto death, even death upon a cross. Risen from the dead, he has freed us from eternal death and given us life everlasting. Therefore, with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven, we laud and magnify your glorious name, evermore praising you and singing.
Thank you.
sent your only begotten Son into our flesh to bear our sin and to be our Savior. With repentant joy we receive the salvation accomplished for us by the all-availing sacrifice of his body and his blood on the cross. Gathered in the name and remembrance of Jesus, we beg you, O Lord, to forgive, to renew, and to strengthen us with your word and spirit. Grant us faithfully to eat his body and drink his blood as he bids us do in his own testament. Gather us together, we pray, from the ends of the earth to celebrate with all the faithful the marriage feast of the Lamb and his kingdom, which has no end. Graciously receive our prayers, deliver and preserve us. To you alone, O Father, be all glory, honor, and worship, with the Son and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
Our Lord Jesus Christ, on the night when he was betrayed, he took bread, and when he had given thanks, he broke it, and he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." In the same way also he took the cup after supper. When he had given thanks, he gave it to them, saying, "Drink of it, all of you. This is my blood of the New Testament, which is shed for you for the forgiveness of sin. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me." As often as we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim the Lord's death until he comes.
Amen. Come, Lord Jesus.
O Lord Jesus Christ, only Son of the Father, in giving us your body and blood to eat and to drink, you lead us to remember and to confess your holy cross and passion, your blessed death, your rest in the tomb, your resurrection from the dead, and your ascension into heaven, and your coming for the final judgment. So remember us in your kingdom and teach us to pray. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always. Body and blood of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, and it strengthen you into life everlasting. Go in peace, knowing that your sins are forgiven, for you are free. In Jesus' name, amen. Please take a moment, be seated, and reflect on this precious gift of grace. Thank you. Please stand. Please sing. Our daily need, and for the support of the poor and those in need. Grant us grace that we receive your gifts with thanksgiving. Use them always to your honor and glory, and return to you the worship of our lips and songs of praise and the fruits of our labor. Trusting that your mercy will not fail us, through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
Now by the God of peace, who brought again from the dead our Lord Jesus, the great shepherd of the sheep, by the blood of the eternal covenant, equipped you with everything good that you may do his will, working in us that which is pleasing in his sight, through Jesus Christ, to whom be glory forever and ever.
Amen.
May the Lord our God bless you and keep you. May he make his face to shine upon you and be gracious unto you. May he lift up his countenance, his favor upon you, and grant you his peace. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you.
Thank you.